Elementor Pro is an additional WordPress tool you need to install and activate besides the free plugin. It will change the way you create a WordPress website completely, and I will show you how each widget works and all the powerful features of this plugin. Hello WordPress enthusiasts, and welcome to another episode about Elementor. My name is Robert, and in this video I will use the first 10 widgets of Elementor Pro. When editing a page with Elementor Pro, there is a section on your sidebar called Pro, which you can see right below the basic widgets. Let's see how these widgets work one by one. The Posts widget will show you your latest posts as default, and you can use a classic skin. Cards, which look really awesome, or full content. You have plenty of settings below, and in the Query tab, you can select the content source, which can be your pages as well. Nice! I will not go through all of these settings in this video. Maybe in a full video tutorial, if you guys want that. Let me know what you want to see about Elementor Pro in the comments section below. I would like to publish videos that are answering your questions and solve your problems. Now let me delete this element and drag over the portfolio widget. The source of this widget can be posts and pages, as well as a manual selection, current query, or related. It's nice how the post title appears when hovering over the images. I like it. Let's go ahead and drag over the gallery widget. I think I can say element instead of widget, right? Either way is correct, I guess. You have to select some images in your media library to populate this widget, which looks nice and has a lot of options to choose from. In the Overlay tab, you can select a title as well as a description that appears over your images on hover. If you set a caption text for your images in the gallery, that caption can come up over your images like so. Let me show you the form widget, but I will delete the gallery element before doing that. As you can see, you get three fields as default for name, email, and message. But you can add new items as well, with 19 different types of content. From simple text to checkbox, file upload, time, date, and so on. I am not sure what the honeypot item is, but if you know, leave a comment below. I will appreciate that. You can customize the submit button and select different actions after submit, which could be a great way to say thank you in a custom page. That can be added over here, after selecting Redirect in the Actions after Submit tab. As additional options, you can set a form ID and custom messages. In the Style tab, you can completely change the look of your form by using separate settings for the form, fields, button, and the messages. There is a style tab available for all of your widgets. Now, let me show you the login widget, which looks pretty much the same as the form widget, but works as your login form and can be placed anywhere on your site. I would not recommend using it on websites without the user registration option enabled. A nice option in additional options is the Redirect After Login, which helps you set a custom page in this field. It can be the user profile, as well as a page with terms and conditions, or rules for using the website. Let's create some slides by using this widget. You have three tabs in the Slide Editor, where you can change the background, content, and also style. You can add more items and adjust the height, then change some slider options like navigation, autoplay, and so on below. The nav menu item coming up, which is a widget you can use to insert custom navigation anywhere on your pages edited with Elementor Pro. Select the menu you want to use in this drop-down and make it look as you want by using the settings below. To create a custom menu, you need to go to the menus screen on your dashboard. Once you create a new menu and save it, when you come back and reload the page, you can see that menu in the drop-down. The ABC animated headline is a great way to catch your visitors' attention and make them understand what you do in a single phrase. For example, I can replace this text and say, "For a stunning, perfect, and modern website." The only thing left is to fine-tune the text in the Style tab and move to the following widget, which is the price list. If you run a restaurant website and want to show people your menu and prices, this widget allows you to create something fast. Just drag it over, edit the items, and make them look as you want in the Style tab. You can add images to your foods as well, which will show up on the left side of your item. If you offer services like personal training or business consultancy, use the price table widget as many times as you want. For example, if you offer three types of services, Start, Basic, and Premium, duplicate the column twice and change the title of each pricing table like so. Then go ahead and change the price as well as the content below and play around with the settings in the Style tab until you get it to match with your website design. This is it, guys, for this video. In the following episode, I will show you the flip box, call to action, media carousel, testimonial carousel, reviews, table of contents, countdown, share buttons, block quote, as well as the Facebook button. To make sure you won't miss my future videos, please subscribe and ring the bell to get notified when I publish them. I will show you a lot of other interesting features for Elementor Pro, so stay tuned. Keep up the good work and see you in the next video. Cheers!